Hello student, MS Arif here. So today we are going to understand the very important part of this chapter called living life processes in living organism. So today we will understand how the life is sustained in an organism. Okay, this is because of the energy. So we will understand today how energy is obtained in living organism to sustain life. So we have to write energy production is our topic. Energy production. Okay, so without energy our body cannot work properly, or it is not going to work. That means the body will get dead when if there is no energy is present. So like our motor vehicles, they runs with the help of fuel called petrol or diesel or gas. Likewise our bodies also run with the help of energy, and the fuel which we are getting is our food that we are taking every day. Okay, so this food act as a fuel for the human body to run sufficiently and work properly so that life can sustain. Okay, so our body is also a type of machine. See, this food which we are taking every day in our diet is converted into the simpler form, which is converted into simpler form so that the absorption of nutrition can be done from the food. Okay, so and in previous lecture we have already understood about the digestion process. Okay, so today we will understand the oxidation of food for the energy production. That is nothing but the respiration. So first we have to understand what is respiration. So respiration is the exchange of gases from body to its surrounding. Okay, so respiration is classified into two main part. So first we will write what is respiration. So respiration is exchange of gas is nothing but our respiration. So respiration is divided into two part. One is external respiration, and second one is internal respiration, or we can say cellular respiration. So internal and external respiration mein difference kya hai? So we had to understand first external respiration. So what is external respiration? The exchange of gases or breathing out of breathing in oxygen rich air from surrounding and breathing out carbon dioxide in surrounding. Is called as external respiration. So respiration, that is external respiration, is nothing but inhalation and exhalation. Inhalation means taking in oxygen rich air from the surrounding into our lungs through nostril and then windpipe to the bronchi and bronchioles, then finally in our alveoli. So this is nothing but the part of lungs. So surrounding se oxygen rich air ko inhale karna is called as inhalation, and carbon dioxide ko body se exhale karna, out karna is called as exhalation. So inhalation plus exhalation equals to our external respiration. Okay, so now what is internal respiration now. So when in lungs blood is absorb oxygen gas, then this blood is circulated to all cell of the body where energy is being produced. So in blood hemoglobin is present, that hemoglobin combines with oxygen and convert into oxyhemoglobin, and that oxyhemoglobin reaches to all individual cells for energy production, and where with in presence of oxygen complete oxidation of glucose takes place. Okay, this process is called as internal or cellular respiration. So what is internal or cellular respiration? Complete oxidation of glucose in presence of O2, that is oxygen gas, is called as internal or cellular respiration. Okay, so it is internal or cellular respiration. So when oxidation of glucose takes place in presence of oxygen, it is called as aerobic respiration. So it is also called as aerobic respiration. So in aerobic respiration, complete oxidation of glucose takes place, that you have to remember. Okay, so now we will understand aerobic respiration in detail. Okay, so write down this part first, then we will move the oxidation of glucose, that is in aerobic respiration. Okay, so write down first. So as we know, in our body the main energy producing nutrients is carbohydrate. So carbohydrate is nothing but the glucose, which formula is C6H12O6. So glucose contain, that is our carbohydrate contain 6 carbon atom in its structure or in its molecular form, where the fully oxidation of glucose molecule takes place in aerobic respiration. So the question is, what happens when the complete oxidation of glucose takes place? See, here we have carbon. So when carbon is fully oxidized, will form carbon dioxide, and when water, that is H2O, is formed by the oxidation of hydrogen. Okay, so in complete oxidation of glucose, carbon dioxide and water molecules are formed by their complete oxidation in aerobic respiration process. Okay, and during the course of time, a tremendous amount of energy is released in the form of ATP, and ATP is adenosine triphosphate. So adenosine triphosphate ke form mein energy release hoti hai, and that energy is used for the individual cell for their work, or we can say for their functioning. Okay, so let understand the oxidation of glucose. See, so this is nothing but the glucose. Okay, so here we have to write glucose. When this glucose reaches to our cell, so we are drawing the cell also. So it is our cell. At the center we have nucleus, this cell membrane. Here different cell organelles like mitochondria are also present. It is mitochondria. All over the cell cytoplasm is present. Then here Golgi complex is also present. Around the nucleus, endoplasmic reticulum is present. Endoplasmic reticulum is nothing but ER. Okay. Then here ribosomes are present. Here lysosomes is present. Okay. So these are nothing but the cell organelles. Okay. So in oxidation of glucose, the main important role played by the cell is in cytoplasm and in mitochondria. Okay. So first glucose is converted into the pyruvic acid. This process is called as glycolysis. So first glucose is converted into pyruvic acid. Pyruvic acid. During the conversion of glucose into pyruvic acid, two molecules of pyruvic acid are formed plus two molecule of NADH2 and two molecule of ATP is formed during the process. Okay. So NADH2, ATP and pyruvic acid are formed. This process takes place only in cytoplasm. So, and this process is called as glycolysis. Glycolysis. And it takes place in cytoplasm. Okay. So glycolysis is the process in which glucose converted into pyruvic acid. This process is called as glycolysis and this process takes place in cytoplasm itself. Okay. So then pyruvic acid converts into acetyl coenzyme A. So we have to write acetyl coenzyme A. So after conversion of glucose from pyruvic acid, then pyruvic acid converted into acetyl coenzyme A, and after acetyl coenzyme A, the process of the oxidation of glucose takes place inside the mitochondria. Okay. So two molecules of acetyl coenzyme A are formed during the process. Then acetyl coenzyme A enters into the mitochondria. Enters into mitochondria. So in mitochondria there are various processes take place in order to complete oxidation of glucose. These processes are called as tricarboxylic acid cycle. So here we have to write TCA. What is TCA? It is tricarboxylic acid cycle, or it is also called as Krebs cycle. Krebs cycle. So the Krebs cycle takes place in mitochondria. Okay. So let's understand one more this part. Pyruvic acid when converted into acetyl coenzyme A, then each molecule of acetyl coenzyme A enters into mitochondria, and then in mitochondria TCA or Krebs cycle is takes place. Okay. So during the course of time, NADH2 plus FADH2 plus ATP plus carbon dioxide plus water molecules are formed. These are the products which are formed when TCA or Krebs cycles takes place. Then NADH2 and FADH2 are formed during the process of Krebs cycle and conversion and glycolysis. They converts into the ATP molecule. This process is called as electron chain transfer reaction. Next process is electron transfer chain reaction. So in electron transfer chain reaction, each NADH2 molecule gives 3 molecule of ATP, and each FADH2 molecule gives 2 molecule of ATP. Okay, so in electron chain transfer reaction, NADH2 and FADH2 are converted into ATP, which are the energy rich molecules. Okay, and when energy is needed to individual cell, these ATP molecules then convert into the energy in the form of the phosphate bond. When each phosphate bond breaks down, they produces energy, and which is used by the cell to sustain life and for functioning of various activity. Okay, so this is the way our complete oxidation of glucose takes place. So first glucose converted into pyruvic acid. This process is called as glycolysis. After glycolysis, then pyruvic acid, which convert into acetyl coenzyme A. Then acetyl coenzyme A enters into the mitochondria, and in mitochondria TCA, that is Krebs cycle, is takes place, where NADH2 and FADH2 molecules are formed. Then NADH2 and FADH2 molecules, they undergoes electron transfer chain reaction to form 3 ATP molecules from each NADH2 molecule and 2 ATP molecules from 1 FADH2 molecule, and this is the way the complete oxidation of glucose takes place. Along with ATP molecule, carbon dioxide and water molecules are also formed. Okay, so we had to write the reaction for this process. So I am writing a reaction over here. See, glucose is C6H12O6. When it completely oxidizes, it gives 6 molecule of carbon dioxide plus 6 molecule of H2O and 38 ATP molecules. In this process, 38 ATP molecules are released, and in adenosine triphosphate, 3 phosphate bonds are present, and when this phosphate bond breaks down, energy is released, and mitochondria takes a very important role in production of ATP molecules. That's why mitochondria is called as the powerhouse of the cell. Okay, so students, I hope aapko aaj ka topic, that is oxidation of glucose, samajh mein aa gaya hoga. So students, aaj ke liye itna hi, milte hain next video.